Hello, and welcome to another of my Kubuntu 11.04, codename Natty Narwhal, tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be explaining how to install and remove programs in Kubuntu. This is done from the Software Management tool, available as part of the system settings or as its own application. You can get to the application from the Computer tab in the K menu or under the System category in the Applications tab. From the Software Management tool, you can browse new applications, view the software you have installed on your computer, perform system updates, and change settings regarding your available software. Let's install some extra functionality for the programs available in Kubuntu. The package we're looking for is called Kubuntu Restricted Extras. We can find it by searching for Extras in the search bar. Here's the package. I can see information about it by clicking the package, and I can set it to install by pressing the Install button. While I'm here, I think I want to install the Chromium browser. I can do so easily by choosing the Internet category, clicking Web Browsers, and choosing Chromium Browser. Even though I've chosen to install two programs, nothing will install until I press the Apply button. But first, I'd like to look at what I've chosen. I can do so using the Pending Changes button in the top right corner. Now, to install the packages, I can press the Apply button. Now we can see the familiar downloading and installing window. I'll fast forward while my computer downloads and installs the programs. Now that the installation is installed, we can run Chromium. We can access them from this window or from the Application Launcher menu. Chromium is the base of Google's Chrome browser. In fact, Chrome has very few differences from Chromium. However, I'm going to show you how to install Chrome anyway, because some applications, including all of Google's, will require you to download a Debian package to install them. To do this, we can simply go to the Google Chrome webpage, choose Download, and select our package. It's important to know here whether you're using a 32-bit or 64-bit version of Kubuntu. However, Google's webpage will detect that for you. The virtual machine I'm using is a 32-bit version, so I'll choose the first option. As with all other software, it's important that you understand the license terms. Fortunately, I've read them before, so I can simply press Accept and Install. This will download the installer for Chrome, which I can then open to install. This package installer is what you'll see every time you open a Debian installer file. Clicking Install Package will ask you for your password, and then it will automatically install Google Chrome. Firefox is a bit of a special case. There's an easy Firefox installer built right into the menus. Going to the Internet category, we can see an icon labeled Mozilla Firefox Browser Installer. Launching it, we're offered a one-click download and installation for Firefox. When it finishes, we can go back to the application menu and launch Firefox. Voila! We now have the latest version of Firefox installed. But there are other ways to install software in Kubuntu as well. For example, the Kubuntu team offer unofficial updates for KDE. Using these updates, we can get the latest stable version of KDE in Kubuntu. From the Kubuntu homepage, we can see the news item announcing the latest update to KDE. From the Settings tab in the Software Management tool, click the Edit Origins button. In the Other Software tab, you can add these updates. This line, ppa:kubuntu-ppa, is the line you need to add. Press the Add button and type or paste that line into the text box presented. Press OK and close the dialog box. Because you've just added a new repository, the system will ask you to refresh your updates. Pressing the Refresh button and waiting for the refresh to take place, we can now go to the Updates tab. From here, we have updates to all of KDE. I'll run those later. If I had added that repository with the goal of installing a new application, I could simply go to the Get and Remove Software tab to find it, like I would with software already in the repositories. There's one more common way to install programs in Kubuntu. Some people call it the traditional way. It's the way you'd install a program in Windows. run an installer. For security reasons, Kubuntu makes it a bit more difficult than Windows does. Each file you download is not executable by default. Earlier, I downloaded the installer for Penumbra Overture, which I bought through the Humble Indie Bundle a while back. It's in my Downloads folder. Right-clicking on the file and choosing Properties brings up the Properties dialog. In the Permissions tab, I can make the file executable by clicking this checkbox. After applying these settings, I can run the file. Press F4 to bring up a terminal. The installer will need to be run as administrator. Type kdesudo, please note the spelling, a space, ./, and the name of the installer. Once you've typed enough of the installer's name to be uniquely identifiable out of the files in the current folder, you can press Tab and the terminal will fill in the rest of the file name for you. After you press Enter, you'll be greeted by a password prompt as you'll be running the installer as administrator. After you follow the instructions presented by the installer, you should have the program available in your application launcher menu. Here it is, exactly as I'd expect it, under Games. I hope this tutorial has been useful in teaching you how to install applications in Kubuntu. My next tutorial will start a series on how to use KDE.